Well, hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com, and today we're going to take a look at this rotoscoping freeze-framed effect here in Adobe After Effects. Here's a little something-something, what it kind of is going to look like when we're finished. There you have it. We're going to cover that effect in After Effects. If you enjoy this video and you're thinking about it as we're progressing through it, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel so you never miss any After Effects Premiere Pro video editing related stuff in the past, present, or future. Guys, let's jump into After Effects and check this thing out right now. Okay, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and I have a single video clip here, and I'm going to right-click and choose to create a new composition from this selection. Now, you want your composition to exactly match the frame rate of the video that we're going to be applying this effect to, because the Roto Brush, which we're going to be using in a little bit, that's the way it works. That's kind of the way it lets you go in and do its thing. It can be a little finicky, but it's really, really cool what it does for you. So first thing I'll do is I'll just right-click and create a new, I'm going to create a new solid, and this can be any random color you want it to be. I think I'll make this, I'll kind of make it like an orangey color, something that's a little faded orange like that, and I'll hit OK. And I'm going to drag this orange beneath. This is just to give us a point of reference. If we punch a hole in something, we'll be like, oh, I'm seeing a big orange circle there. I know I've cut a hole in it. I think it'll help with the explanation process later. I can't quite remember how, but I'm just following my notes here. So we'll see if we actually use it later on. Now, we've got this first video clip. I'm going to hit the Enter Return key to rename. And this one, I'm going to name it Base-Video. And I'm going to duplicate it, Command-Control-D. I'm going to hit Enter Return again. This one, I'm going to name Kick-Freeze. And then I'm going to hit Command-Control-D. And the third copy of this video, I'm going to name Kick-Keyed-Front. So a few layers of effects go into making this thing work. And we're going to cover it all right now. So let's go ahead and hide base video, and we'll also hide kick keyed front, just so we can work on isolating the actual frozen position that we want. So I'm going to double click here on the kick freeze video clip. I'm going to double click. It's going to bring me, you can see in here, to this layer panel, which is not our initial composition. We're within the layer here. And I'm going to move out to about the 217 mark. So I'm just watching this timer right down here. I'm just going to move out to about the 217 mark. I happen to know that that's where I want this thing to be frozen, right there. Right as his foot is coming in contact with the ball, this is the frame that we would like frozen. And now what I'll do is go Layer, Time, and I'm going to choose Freeze Frame. It's going to apply this time remap, which is basically going to lock this frame as essentially the entire video clip. It's sort of like doing a frame hold. And now I'm going to hang out there around 217 again, and I'm going to grab this tool here called the Roto Brush. And what I'll do with this, I'm going to zoom in on my video a little bit. You want to be at least 100% with your video, or you can go a little bit beyond. I'm at 200% here. My brush is a little bit too big, so you can hold down your Command or Control key and drag up or down in order to increase or decrease the size of the brush. And the idea with the brush is you just draw kind of up across the middle. I like to make what amounts to a loose outline of my object that I'm looking to encircle. So you can see I've done this, and After Effects has gone ahead and said, all right, I think I see the object that you're looking to encircle, but because I dragged over the yellow sky a little bit, it included all that, and it missed his entire arm and part of the ball. No problem. We can just draw here and say, yeah, grab that part of the ball. Yep, that looks good. And then, oh, by the way, over here, his arm. This is all stuff that we want as well. It's a little messy, picking up a little bit of the gravel, but not too bad yet. We do, in fact, want his shoulder and a little bit of the wrinkle in the clothing there. Great. And this whole bit between his legs, hold down the Alt or Option key and just say, yeah, this is a bridge too far. We need to get rid of that. And I think that's pretty good. I mean, you could trim this up here on his leg right down there. Just make sure this is all kind of cleaned up. And you can go over it, Alt or Option to get rid of a bit of the sort of selection, if you will, and the just regular click and drag to go ahead and add to that selection. I'm also over here in the Effect Controls panel. I'm just going to adjust the feather to like 7. I want to push it up a little bit, just kind of smooth and blur it just a touch more. This really does not at all have to be amazingly perfect, because we're going to be reducing the opacity of the piece that's frozen in time enough that I don't think you're really going to be able to see too much of a really messy edge if we have an edge that's being particularly problematic. In fact, if you are having an edge that's particularly problematic, there is a nice little tool here, the Refine Edge Brush Tool. Hold down Command or Control again and just click and drag to make the brush a little bit bigger. And we can just paint over edges like this. And you're going to get this weird edge, but basically what's happening is the white area is going to become part of the rotoscope selection. The black area is just going to be kicked to the curb. So I'll say, yeah, go ahead and clean up the edge of his arm there. Yep, that all looks pretty good. And, you know, here on his hand where it's a little messy, we'll see what that can do for us. Cool. We could try the bottom of the shoe as well. And it's important that in this stage, spend the time now to get a decent selection. Because as we tweak the roto later, all of this is going to kind of, it's going to have a bearing, or it's going to have bearing, I should say, on the way our rotoscope looks. Now, one thing you may have noticed, or maybe you didn't, we got all these little arrows, right, to the left and the right of our little playhead marker here. Well, this is the area in which the rotoscope brush has begun trying to track his object and his movement. But remember, we froze time with this time remap, or really the time freeze, so there's never going to be any change. So once we get our initial selection, it is what we want it to be. So I'm going to go ahead real quick, and I'm just going to keep extending it. I'm going to drag this little playhead all the way to the edge, give After Effects just a moment to mess around. In fact, if you have to, you can grab the Roto Brush and just click once, like right solidly in the middle of an area we have selected, and you can see how it's extended our arrows. And I'm assuming there's got to be a better way to do this. I just haven't run into it yet. I'll just click a single time here, and it'll extend it. I do know from Adobe people, they only have the Roto Brush extending a certain amount in any direction because they just don't see why anybody would need to go further than that. Well, here's one reason why. Maybe you're making just a nice selection like this. And there we have it. We have our arrows extended generously on both sides. And I really didn't need to take it to 7 seconds. I just wasn't really thinking. Sometimes, I mean, I know I'm dumb most of the time, but sometimes I'm particularly dumb. And at this point, I should have known that right after 217, we're basically going to fade this out immediately. So I only needed to really go to like 4 seconds max. But anyway, I've got this arrow selected over this whole area. We're looking good. We can close this layer here with kick freeze. And you can see here, we've got him isolated above what we now see as our orange background, right? It's making it very clear. Yep, you got him isolated. There's nothing else you can see. So what I'll do now, back in the original composition, I'm going to turn the base layer back on, and you can see our guy is just kind of floating above the actual proper soccer player in the back, and they both meet beautifully and harmoniously at 217, which is exactly what we want to happen. But what we need to do is make him a little more semi-opaque. So let's move about 10 frames in. I'm just going to type in the number 10 here in my time code, and we're going to hit the letter T, which is going to bring up our transparency option, and I am going to drop, well, I'm going to set my opacity to, I don't know, let's try like 50%, something like that, and I'm going to drop a keyframe right there, and then I'll move back to the very beginning, so this is at frame 0, and I'm going to set the opacity to 0. So what'll happen is the sort of ghost version of him will float in or just fade in very quickly, and then the video will continue to play, and the two of them will meet up, and we need to make it so as soon as he strikes the ball, the ghost version of him disappears. You never see it again. So what we'll do, we'll move out to, you can see here's our timer. We need to get to 216. So 217 is exactly where they line up. You can see here it is. They're not quite lined up, but they're close. So with opacity, I'm going to drop a keyframe. Whoop, I don't want to drop a keyframe by hitting the add or remove keyframe button like that. And the opacity here is still at full 50%. And then we move one keyframe down the timeline by hitting Command or Control and the right arrow key. Now we're at 217. Our layers are perfectly aligned. All we need to do now is drop our opacity to 0%. That's going to make our little clip just disappear. Now, there are ways you can trim it off, of course, but we're here in our animation flow, so I figure I'll just let that ride. And just a quick render here, and we can test and see what it looks like. So there we go. Looks pretty cool. The only problem is, of course, the ghosty version is appearing above the guy kicking the ball. That's why we have this kick keyed out front, because we actually want him to appear in front of the ghost version while the base video does its thing behind all of this. So once more, we'll turn this layer on. Everything goes away, all the effects that we just did, because we're covering it up. I'm going to double-click to get within this layer. We're here within this layer. And we can, one more time, use the Roto Brush right here, Roto Brush. And we'll just make a selection over him, so I can just draw a line right down the middle of him. Well, actually, that got a lot of him there, didn't it? And hold down Command or Control, drag down a little bit, and I can just clean this stuff up by holding Alt or Option, just painting that little bit away. Hold the space bar to get your Move tool. And I'm going to just play through this a little bit, and I can see, you can see we're not getting the ball. I want to make sure the ball is included. Now, I only have to make sure he's rotoscoped up until the 2 second and 17 frame mark, because at that point, the whole video is just synced up perfectly, and he can disappear. So I'm just going to make sure that everything that needs to be included here is included. And of course, clear anything out, Alt or Option, and just get rid of that gravel back there. You know, again, we're trying to get it close enough. That's kind of the name of the game here, is just close enough. So I hit spacebar again. We're playing through it. I'm just watching and watching and watching. I'm going to zoom back in here. And I can see I've got all this extra stuff selected. I don't know that I like that. I want to move back a couple frames because all of that's going to look really bad over the other effects. So I'm going to hold down Alt or Option. I'm going to say, yeah, just trying to get some of that yellowish stuff out. But I do want to keep the bulk of the rest of the ball, kind of something like that. Make sure we pick up the tip of his shoe. And After Effects is just building out the appropriate animations for us. So it's taking and just doing all that heavy lifting, boring rotoscoping, or not really boring, but just tedious rotoscoping stuff for us. You can see how it's automatically readjusting everything for us as we go. So I'm going to back this out. The ball, we probably don't need to worry about the ball when it's all the way out there because I don't think it'll be covering up anything. We definitely want to get the toe of his shoe there and, of course, the rest of his leg just like that. And again, as long as it's pretty close, you don't want to get too much gravel, though. That's going to look really bad or have a chunk of his leg missing. That also, I found, tends to look pretty bad. And we can move this back a little bit further and see. Yeah, we still don't have his leg back here. So we'll just, you know, After Effects should be filling in between the frames here a little bit. And like, you know, in between here and there, we should be getting his leg. All right, so we still don't have his leg here, moving backward. I'm going to undo that because I picked up a little bit too much gravel. I'm going to try coming through the foot and then down the leg here. I'm going to move down a little. I'm going to pull this back to the point where we're editing where we were. I'm going to cut off the gravel. And I'm going to say, yeah, just can we pick up his foot? How about his foot? How about the foot? And I think there we have it. We really only need to get up to 217 done reasonably. And I'll close this out now. And because all this is timed up together, what we're going to get is a video that really only shows this keyed out guy jumping in the front up until 217 when everything melds back to kind of the base video at the beginning. Now, as I'm watching through this, maybe we would go back in there and just feather the edges a little more. Again, everything's kind of the same color because it's the same exact video track. So I'll just go ahead and say, yeah, look, feather this like 10. Something like that should be pretty good for us. And, you know, he'll move through and boom. And right there at 217, everything becomes normal. Again, let's close out. We're in this layer, not our original composition. So I'll just close out the layer. And now if I do a quick little pre-render, we can play through this and you can see that, in fact, we get that full effect. Now, of course, what's happening here is this top clip is just simply that keyed out guy or that rotoscoped out guy really that we just did, and he's there just so he looks like he's on top of his ghosty shape. If we shut him off, then of course the ghost is the kick freeze frame, and then base video is just the underlying video, just making sure that everything is filled in and looking good. And as soon as that clip fades away, we're just back to the regular video again and everything looks normal as it should. You would never know that there was any kind of crazy effect like that that we just created. And that is really it for creating this little rotoscope freeze framed effect. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure again you subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you didn't, or well, if you didn't enjoy the tutorial, still subscribe to the channel because you might enjoy the next video. But if you're on Instagram, make sure you go ahead and follow me on Instagram at tutvid. Or if Discord is more your kind of flow, your pace, we've got a Discord server as well, discord.me/tutvid. A nice little community over there that's just waiting for you to join and come along with us. For working with the Roto Brush and all the other stuff we cover in this tutorial, from duplicating layers and semi-opaqueness and just timing stuff up to look just right, that's it. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodds and tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.